What is going on, you boys and girls? I hope you guys are having a phenomenal day today. So we are going to be doing a video today, one that I've been meaning to do for a little while now. Haven't gotten to it, but we're doing it today, and I'm excited about doing it. I'm so glad you guys are here with me. Please make sure, if you haven't subscribed to the channel, hit that subscribe button and give me a thumbs up on this video. Let me know in the comment section if you liked it and if you want to see more videos like this in the future. So now, without further ado, let's get into it. So we're going to be doing, this isn't going to be a big order for mana, but these are just a handful of cards that I just basically wanted to get graded. Oh, you know what? I actually forgot one now that I'm thinking about it. I forgot one. 2 seconds. 2 seconds. There he is. But we're also, like I said, with this mana grading video that we're doing, I am going to be showing you guys the card. We're going to be seeing what they could be, what they might get. We're going to make a guess, and then when we get the cards back, we're going to do the video, and we're going to see if we got the guess right. So, here we go. Let's get into it. Starting it off, we've got a beautiful, beautiful Elemental Hero, Dark Neos, from Power of the Duelist. This is a very, very nice card. Pulled this card myself. I'm trying to think. Yeah, almost all the cards I pulled except for three of them. So, this is going to be our first one that we're going to be submitting. The only reason I'm submitting it personally, I just think that this would be a good card to have sent in. It looks very good. I mean, there's no scratching on the foiling. It's relatively centered very well. I mean, the corners look good. The back does look a little off-centered, but, you know, I'm okay. Like, generally speaking, when it comes to grading companies, they don't hurt you too bad. I mean, unless the card is, like, just way off-centered. Like, it has to be pretty bad in order for it to be, you know, hit on centering, generally speaking. So, yeah, that's the first one. I think that one has a very good chance at... I think that one has a good chance of getting a 10. I'm going to go out on a limb and say, it's not going to get a perfect 10. Now, make sure you understand, with mana grading, they give 10s, which comes in gold lettering, which means that, you know, everything is generally perfect, except for maybe a minute little thing. Then they give a flawless 10, which it comes in blue lettering. And that one is just, the card itself is literally perfect. Like, there's nothing else that could be done to make it better. So, I don't think it's going to get a blue flawless 10. I think it'll get a gold 10, and I'm okay with that. So, all right, next up we have, I really like this card, Dragon of the Ice Barrier. I pulled this from a pack that Nick at GG Vision sent me. It was a mystery box that I bought from him, and he included the pack that this came in. And it's a very beautiful card. This is a very, I mean, this card is very, very good looking. It is just, I mean, flawless. I mean, the back, my goodness, the back is even better than the front. Like, I would say the back is actually better centered than the front. So, yeah. And like I said, I don't want to, like, I went through and I was like, I want to send in some stuff to get graded by mana. So I picked just, I wanted to get meaningful cards, like cards that are valuable, but I also was like, there are some cards that I'm like, oh, I'd love to get this graded, but it's not going to get a 9. It's not even going to get a 9. So I was really careful about what I decided to pick. I think this has a chance at getting another gold 10 grade. And like I said, most of these will possibly be gold 10s. Maybe some will get flawless. I doubt it. Flawless is really hard to get, but we'll see what happens. This is the one that I forgot to grab out of my binder. I pulled this from, this was the, so the card that you just saw, the Dragon of the Ice Barrier. So the mystery box that Nick sent me, this pack came in it as well, and I pulled this one. This is probably one of the better pulls you can get from this particular set. So let's take a look at her. Let's take a look at him and see how good he is. He, I, The corner actually looks a little dinged up here. Yeah, like right there. You guys could maybe see it. I mean, I could definitely see it. Oh, yeah, there we go. See that corner? That corner has got some wear and tear on it. Looks okay, though. I think that corner is really going to be hard, though, on it. I don't think this is going to get a 10. Like, honestly, if I really had to guess, I'd say this one, the Magician of Black Chaos. I'm going to say this will get like a 9, possibly a 9.5. It's just, I think that corner is really going to hurt it. But like I said, I need to put that top loader, though. But I really want to just, this is one that I really want to get graded just because it's an older card. But also, I've kind of gotten to the point where some cards that I really like, I'm like, oh, this is a personal card. Because for the most part, guys and girls, I don't grade cards that I don't typically pull unless they're like really valuable. And you'll see why here in a minute. So yeah, that Magician of Black Chaos, I think 9, 9.5. I'm going to go with the 9 to be safe because I think the 9 is probably safer. Because I'm getting AI graded with all these cards. Like AI grading 100%. So, all right, this next one, Tyrant Red Dragon Archfiend. Absolutely love this card. This one is definitely off-centered. It's very, like, I pulled this myself as well. This card particularly looks, I mean, it's flawless in reference to scratches. I mean, there's nothing wrong with the corners. The back looks immaculate. Yeah, I mean, it's as good as it can get. It is, like I said, it is off-centered quite a bit. But generally speaking, that's probably the most off-centered card we've gotten so far. That's probably, honestly, I'm going to go with a 9.5 on this one because I just think that this one is way off-centered. But this, I love this card. This was from, I'll put it up in the editing where the sets, what set these are a part of. I can't remember all of them, so give me a break. That one is definitely going to be a 9.5 in reference to the centering, so yeah. Next up, we have my error print. Gaia, the Dragon Champion, Secret Ultra Rare. I got this from my good friend Ray. He sold me a whole mess of his cards a while back. This card, I was very on the fence with it in reference to getting it graded because this card, I don't know, I might not get it graded. It's very, like, I mean, it's this might be light play, maybe mod play even. The card itself looks great, and I've really grown to love the, there's some scuffing on the back there. Yeah, and there's some corner damage. There's a top, like, right there. I don't know, but I really have gotten to love collecting and grading error cards. I've actually collected and graded quite a few of them. Let's put this in here carefully because I really don't want to damage this thing any more than it already is. Not that this was Ray's fault. Ray was very up forward with me. He's like, dude, this is not like a clean 100%, you know, near mint card. And I said, you know what, Ray, that's all good, man. I really appreciate your honesty. He is 100% trustworthy. And I've bought from him on 3 separate occasions now that I'm thinking about it. Yeah, I think 3 separate occasions. So he has been absolutely wonderful. This is going to be a lower graded card. But me personally, the main thing about this is getting this in a slab. I love the error cards. So this is just mainly about getting in a slab. This is from the Legend of Blue Eyes. This is the unlimited printing of it. This is definitely going to probably, I mean, it's pretty beat up. I'm going to go with a 7.5 because I really just think that there's stuff wrong with this card. You know, it's a play card. It was a played card. That's all there is to it. And Ray or whoever, if Ray played with this when he was a kid or whoever Ray got it from, played with this card as a kid. Granted, you know, it's still in decent shape, being that this is like almost a 20-plus-year-old card. So I think 7.5 is a very reliable guess on that. We'll see. I don't know. Okay, now we're getting into the big ones, the heavy, heavy, heavy hitters. Now, this is some really great stuff. Blue Eyes White Dragon, BPT-009. Now, all these cards that are coming up here are extremely valuable and have potential, especially the two that I'm going to show you first. The two that I'm going to show you first, if they get high grades, they have extreme potential to be very, very expensive. So, let's go ahead and get into this. This is another one of them sleeves. This looks like it might be a little bit lower of a grade, but I don't believe that it's going to be a 9 or a 10. I got this from Ray as well, but this one actually wasn't that bad, all things considering. There's the corner. There's a little ding down here at the corner on the bottom left corner. What else we got here? There is some scuffing on the back. And like I said, Ray was very upfront with me about it. He's like, look, dude, these aren't that great. They're not like near mint condition. So I'm not faulting Ray for this. I knew exactly what I was getting into when I bought these. It was mostly, yeah, there's some scuffing on the back there. The corners don't look bad, all things considering. But it's not too bad, though. I mean, honestly, if I really had to give this one, I think that this one could get... I think this one has the potential to get a 9. But I'm not going to do it. I'm going to go with an 8.5 because, like I said, I'm getting AI grading, and they are 1,000,000% better than PSA because PSA is... I'm just going to go ahead and say it. I'm going to get it out of the way. PSA is garbage. And I know some people like grading with PSA. That's fine. I'm not saying that you're unwise for doing it by any means. I personally do not like PSA. The reason being is because PSA is so random with their grading. There isn't any logic behind it. Because I've gotten cards graded from them, and I got horrible grades. Dark Paladin is the example I'm using here. And the reason why I'm pissed off about it is because Dark Paladin, there was nothing wrong with the card. I knew for a fact it was not a 10. It was not a 10. I 8 or a 9, I would have been good with. But the fact is that they gave me an absolutely horrible grade because, in my opinion, what ended up happening was I think the grader came to work that day because his girlfriend dumped him and he was pissed off at the world, or she was pissed off at the world, whatever the case may be. I really think that's what happens because they do not have a logical, solid foundation of grading. It is all at the, it's basically all at the discretion of the grader. And that's okay, but the fact is that they don't all follow the grading process logically. They don't. I mean, I don't care what anybody says. So, anyway, now that I've ranted on about that, let's get to the next one. Yes, Blue Eyes. Oh, I got somebody calling me. Who's this? Oh, that's my mother. I need to call her back. Okay. Sorry, guys. We got Blue Eyes, BPT-003. I got this one from Card Breaker. Really excited about this one. This was one that I... a lot of fuzz on this thing. Goodness gracious. A lot of fuzz on that thing, but, you know, nothing... It's nothing that's... yeah, it's fine. It's just fuzzing. I don't know where that came from, but... We got Blue Eyes White Dragon. This is a beautiful, beautiful copy of Blue Eyes White Dragon. I've definitely, as I said before... Ooh, that's got some scuffing there in the back. Oof. That might hurt it. That's some pretty, that's notable scuffing. It's very easy to see, but like I said before, it's kind of tragic because, well, let me just double check this sleeve. Maybe the sleeve was what did it. Because sometimes, guys and girls, sleeves can damage cards. That's why you have to be very, very, very careful about what you use. I really, truly cannot tell you what the best sleeves to use are. I'm going to go ahead and actually sleeve this up in a penny sleeve. If you don't know or if you're worried about it, I mean, just go with a penny sleeve. That's my advice to you guys and girls. Just go with a penny sleeve. They're bigger and they're a little bit more flimsy, if you will. So, yeah. So this has that scuffing in the back. I mean, it's kind of tragic, but you know, it's not that bad. Like, I mean, I don't blame Cardbreaker at all for this because he gives great products. I'm gonna go with a 9 on this one. Which is kind of upsetting because I looked it up. A graded 10 of this would be like $1,500. So, but that's okay. Like I said, that's not, I mean, I still want to get it graded on the sole fact of like just cards that I really like and appreciate. So, all right, this is a real big one. Oh, this is, y'all are going to like this one. And I'm really, really, I really hope and pray that this is a really high grade. 10, hopefully. We'll see. Let's see what we got here. Let me get it out nice and carefully. I bought this also from Cardbreaker. Look at that beautiful Dark Magician girl. Magician's Force. Oh, my word. Okay. Now, I remember he did tell me that there was a slight ding up top, and you can see it right here. Let me zoom in just a little bit. You can barely, like right there, you can barely see it. There is a slight ding, but the best part, ooh, that's got scuffing. That's like, that's a little, oh man, that's, oof. Honest to God, I don't know what that's going to do. That's some pretty noticeable scuffing in the back there. He did tell me, like, he's like, this is not a, he was like, this is not an Ear Mint card. He was very, like I said, he was very honest with me about it, which is fine. You know, after seeing all that under the light and everything, I was really kind of hoping that maybe it would be a 10, but it's not going to get a 10. I mean, let's be real here. I'm going to go with a 9. I'm going to go with a 9. I'm just going to go with the 9 because that's more of a hope and a dream that it'll be a 9 because this card, oh my word, even unlimited, if that card got like a 10, like, man, you talking about valuable. So, all right, so that's the second to last card. That was not the big card. The big card is yet to come. I am going to collect a lot of hate from this probably. Because the card that I'm getting graded, people are probably like, you need to do with Beckett or CGC or PSA or whatever. You know, I'm not necessarily disagreeing with you. I think that you guys are probably right about that. But like I said before, I partner with Mana, and quite frankly, I've considered grading with other companies just to get like a slab of collections of different companies. Yeah, I'm doing it, everybody. I'm doing it. Blue Eyes, White Dragon, my Dark Duel Stories. This is a $2,000 card, and like I said before, I know a lot of you are like, what are you doing? Why would you do that? This I won from Cardbreaker. I had no idea what it was because, quite frankly, I just didn't know what it was. So there is some, like, oh man, that's a little tragic. It is very off-centered on the back. And on top of that, like, there is some little nicks and crannies on the back there. I have not taken this thing out of the sleeve. This thing has been in this thing ever since I pulled it. I have not taken it out. This is the first time it's come out of the sleeve. Tragically, this is kind of one of those, oh man, this sucks, but I mean, it is. I'm gonna do the penny sleeve because I don't want to stick it in that tight sleeve. But I mean, it is what it is. I mean, it's still. I mean, still raw. This is a very valuable card. I am gonna go because I mean, this is just kind of real tragic that this scuffing or scratching, chipping, whatever you want to call it, on the back is very upsetting. But it's one of those things where I'm like, I mean, what do you do? I'm gonna go with a 9. I think a 9 would be very reasonable. So we're gonna go with a 9 on that with Manta grading. And as I said before, I know you guys are gonna get all like, what are you doing? Don't get that graded with Manta. I cannot within good faith send it into PSA because I just know that PSA, they're just gonna be like, I had a bad day today, so I'm gonna get over to 6. I mean, I just know they're gonna do that because I just freaking hate PSA. It's a little unfair. I'm being a little harsh on PSA. PSA is extremely I mean, they are the standard when it comes to grading, so I acknowledge this. I just don't like PSA. I mean, I just don't like them. So I'm going with Mana. You guys bash me in the comments section. I'm ready for it. I understand. Believe you me, I get it. I'm also a commenter on people's videos, so I get it. And it's okay. I won't take it personal. I think you guys are great. Thanks for being here, guys. So I'm really excited about this. Make sure you subscribe. Give me a thumbs up if you enjoyed this video. And let me know down in the description what you guys think these cards are going to get in reference to grading. I would love to hear from you. So thanks again, everybody. Be safe, and I'll see you guys on the next video. Thanks again.